Today we're going to quickly get a Metahuman animated, body, hands, and face, with our demo PoseCamera app, available on iOS. We can't share Metahuman projects, but you can build this in minutes. The Metahuman blueprints have been updated quite a bit by Epic since we first posted. This replaces our older tutorial, and now things are actually much, much simpler. First, import your favorite Metahuman into the project. Check the Unreal documentation if you don't know how. Now, check to make sure you have the free PoseAI plugin installed in Unreal. It's available on the Unreal Marketplace. Then, find the blueprint for your Metahuman in the content browser and open. With the new Metahuman blueprint, we can make all the changes in one place. You don't need to modify the animation blueprints anymore, unless you want to add our inverse kinematic nodes or tweak the animations. The most important edit is adding our PoseAI movement component to the blueprint. Click the Add button on the top left and find the component. Most of our helper methods can be dragged from this component. I'll delete these nodes for space, and then let's drag the component into the blueprint. We use it to add a live link source. We have two choices, one where you assign the port, and one which automatically uses the next port. This is convenient, but make sure you are connecting to the right port. Next, drag off the handshake pin and make a new handshake. The handshake is the main API, and it allows you to configure our AI and the app running on your phone. You can expand to show all the options. I'm going to use the desktop mode, which means my phone is on my desk next to my monitor, and I only care about upper body. I also switched the hand model to version 2. You can try both. Right now, desktop only uses body model 2, but we will change that in the future. So the new Metahuman blueprint already has configuration options for live link. We need to set the subject names, so add setter nodes for live link body subject and ArcKit face subject. And we'll also add a setter node for the live link body retarget variable. The subject names tell live link which source to use for animating the character. Okay, from the PoseAI movement node, you can drag and find two functions, get subject name and get subject face name. These names are assigned by our plugin, so connect them to the setter nodes. We'll also set the live link body retarget node to use our PoseAI retarget asset. This just tells live link to only use rotations for most of the joints and ignore bone translations. Most of the Metahuman setup happens at construction, but this setup happens at begin play. So let's copy the face setup node from below and connect it here to make sure it gets run after our setup is applied. And then either copy or just connect below to the live link setup and the set update animation and editor nodes, which does the rest of the setup for us. We need to set the default of the two booleans, use ArcKit face, and use live link body to true. Select them and tick their default boxes. We are mostly done. For good housekeeping, add an event end play node and close the live link source with it. Otherwise, each time you start and stop your game, you will create a new source on a new port and the system will get confused. Remember, live link sources can persist in the editor and outside the game. Save and compile, we are ready. Switch to the main view and hit the play button. You should be able to connect our app now to Unreal. And hopefully your Metahuman is now responding to your movements, hands, arms, and face if you are on desktop, or full body if you switch modes. You may want to build more advanced animation blueprints to use inverse kinematics or other features. The key element in the animation blueprints are the live link pose nodes. For simple projects, you could just manually set the live link source. This is how we name them. You may need to change the port number. Happy animating, and until next time.